Screen TV, brought to you by TCU Financial Group. We'll help get you there.
The line took a hit with Patty going down. Maybe Corey, just talk about the big changes there now.
Well, you know, it's always tough when anytime the roster has to change a little bit because you've set one thing. And, you know, we had meetings last night. So there's a couple other guys that we're going to rotate at the position and see what we can do there. Some non-import guys and step up. You know, there's guys like Ben who's been a six that now it kind of moves him into the starting deal. And then somebody else has to step up and be a six. So that's why, you know, we have a pretty good depth there. So we'll see how they go in the next week or so and then in the preseason game.
What's the update on Pat?
I saw him walk out just like you guys did. So once I get with Ivan and the medical staff, I have a better understanding of where he is right now. But, you know, he's out and we'll count him out until I know what the exact time frame of him coming back.
How much does this hurt the ratio if he can't start?
Well, two things. One, our final roster hadn't been set. But as far as the ratio, last year we played with eight. Now we had the ability to play with nine non-imports. So we don't play it as close as most other teams. So we can make some changes there if we wanted to go import, and we would still be good as far as ratio.
What are your thoughts on training camp, you know, going into the second week? How is the team shaping up? And what are you seeing kind of in terms of improvements and places that need to be improved?
That's a great question. Thank you. yeah. Well, you know, it's heading to the second week. First week, you know, and then we had our mock game and we ended, you know. And I thought we were able to evaluate some things. Now you're going to the second week. We want to prepare these guys and get their mindsets ready for a game heading into this preseason game. So, you know, that kind of changes the swing of things. Like today, we took a road trip today. So that's something that we got to get used to doing is going on the road and getting those guys ready for real life situations.
And how did you like Ben Heenan at right tackle today?
You know what? I just checked after practice. I was just doing an overall evaluation. I didn't even notice that he was there. Just as long as they don't touch the quarterback, I'm good. Whoever's there, as long as they can protect the quarterback.
You brought two imports, Valdez and Hill also got a bit of time. Does that give an opportunity so they can see ahead of the time?
Well, you know, like I said, when you look at the preseason, all those guys are going to get some time. And, you know, that's why I said the final roster hasn't been set yet. So it'll be good to see those guys and see how they perform in a game-type situation with the lights on, with all the different, cadences and all that different things, and see how they perform against, those good O-line, good D-line over there in Edmonton.
Dominic Picard was missing from today, too, and I saw walking ago. Can you update on Dominic? Is just
You know what? I don't know what those guys are doing over there, but no, Don was missing today, too, so he's down for a bit. I probably expect him back, if not this afternoon, but in the morning, but he'll be okay.
On the other side of the injury front, talk about Ricky Foley coming back. How close is he to returning the lineup?
You know, I think I saw Ricky do some he progressed today. I think he did some running on the field, and he went through some walkthrough drills and all that, so I expect Ricky back in the next couple of days. It's one of those things to where, you know, with him and Weston, you know what they can do as players, and that's not giving them the out. But, you know, these are guys that we want to be able to count on, so we want to make sure that, you know, they're ready to go. Will they be 100% when they go? No, but we want them at least to the 80, 85% range so those guys can start working back in there and give us some help.
Well, drafting offensive lineman with your first-round pick and keep testing that philosophy.
I tell you what, Brendan Tamman, he has something working. He knows what's going on there. No, it's just one of those that we want to have depth. That was a key area, and we always know it, that we want to be prepared for anything that happens in that area, and I think it's been good to be able to do it, and we'll see how these young guys, how they react to the opportunity. Well, the biggest thing I want to tell them is just to make sure that, you know, they go out there and play full speed and make sure that they show what they can do. Also, we're just trying to make sure that, you know, that we're getting the mindset of how to play football games, you know, that we're an intelligent football team. We want to look at the penalties and all those other things. Right now, like I said, the guys are getting their mind right to get ready to go on a road trip and play a football game.
What was the reasoning behind Bryce McCall's release?
You know what? That's one of those that it was a mutual decision. You know, he had some other things that he thought about or that, you know, drove him as far as a human being. So football is for some people to a certain point in their life, and then they move on. So, yeah, that's all I can say about that.
The road trip here, your thoughts?
It's a nice facility here. That's good. And some of the guys were a little dazed, you know, because they were used to a routine. So it kind of got them out of their routine. And we started a little slow this morning, even with the weather. You know, it was a change. But I thought we finished fast and we did some good things.
Any decisions made on who plays Friday night
yet? You know, we've talked about that. But, you know, every time you make it, then another guy comes up with a little injury or a bruise. So I think whoever's the healthiest on Wednesday, that's who's going to be able to go.
Is Darren going to play at all?
Darren will play in this game.
Why were you here? Why did you come?
Because of training camp.
I know that, but why? You know what I mean. Why would you give a stadium?
Yeah, it was track and field. Okay. Somebody had already had the field booked, so we just went ahead and came here, Murray.
Did I miss a whole week of training camp?
Yeah.